Good afternoon to one and all present. I am Dr. Vasundhara, Assistant Professor, Department of Economics, Government College for Women, Kolar. In previous class, we discussed about arithmetic mean individual series. In arithmetic mean, we find three kinds. They are individual series, discrete series, and continuous series. In last class, we came to know about individual series. In today's session, I would like to explain discrete series. Here we find two methods, direct method and shortcut method. Students should know, they should be having knowledge of both the methods, but in exam, they should follow only one method, whichever they feel convenient. Discrete series. Let me explain direct method first. Direct method. To find out the total of items in discrete series, frequency of each value is multiplied with the respective size. The values so obtained are totaled up. This total is then divided by the total number of frequencies to obtain arithmetic mean. The steps involved in the calculation of mean are as follows. Steps. First one, multiply each size of item by its frequency, that is fx. Add all the summation fx. Third step, divide summation fx by the total of frequency. You should remember the steps so that you can solve the problem very easily. Formula is given like this. This is x bar. Read it as x bar or arithmetic mean is equal to summation fx by n. Summation. This is the symbol which indicates summation. Summation fx by n. Arithmetic mean is equal to summation fx by n. Summation fx, which indicates sum of products, n which means total number of items. In exam also, you should explain these things properly so that it will fetch good marks. Problem is given like this. Calculate mean from the following data. We find two columns, that is value, another column frequency. So in individual series we find only x values. You should know the difference between individual series and discrete series. In individual series we find only x values, in discrete series we find frequencies. Solution to the problem. We already came to know two columns, that is x values are given in the problem. Frequency values are given in the problem. In order to solve the problem, we should find out this column, that is fx column. How we get this fx column? If we multiply f with x values, f which indicates frequencies, this is x value. If we multiply f with x value, we get fx value. For example, 21 into 1, 21. That means 21 ones are 21. 32s are 60. 28 threes are 84. 44s are 160. 26 fives are 130, and so on. If we sum up all frequency values, we get n value, that is 300. The same way, if we sum up all fx values, we get summation fx. If we add all these values, we get summation fx. In this problem, the value for summation fx, that is 1716, n value 300. Formula is read as x bar is equal to summation fx by n. Now we came to know the values of summation fx and n. That is, the value of summation fx is 1716. The value of n 300. If we simplify this, that is 1716 divided by 3, we get 5.72. This is the value of x bar or average. Then next step in discrete series, shortcut method. Previously we came to know direct method related to discrete series in arithmetic mean. We should know properly the steps. Discrete series, shortcut method, steps. The first and foremost step in the shortcut method, that is first one, take any value as assumed mean. Should remember that, take any value as assumed mean. Find out deviations of each variable from assumed mean. Next step, multiply the deviation with the respective frequencies. One more step, add up the products. Apply the formula. How to read this formula? X bar is equal to a plus or minus summation fd by n. You should know how to read the formula first. X bar is equal to a plus or minus summation fd by n. X bar, which means arithmetic mean, a which indicates assumed mean, summation fd, that is sum of total deviations, n which means total frequency. You should remember these steps. Problem is given like this. Calculate mean from the following data. Values column is given. Frequency column is also given. The problem. Solution to the problem, that is calculation of arithmetic mean. I already told you that take any value as assumed mean. Take any value as assumed mean from x values. Here, how to read the formula? X bar is equal to a plus or minus summation fd by n. First thing, we should find out this d column. D which means x minus a. You should remember this. Don't get confused. D is equal to x minus a. D which means deviations of each variable from assumed mean. Let me repeat this. D which means each variable from assumed mean. So, D is equal to x minus a. You can take any value as assumed mean from x values. So that in this case, I have taken 5 as my assumed mean. So that how to simplify this? D is equal to x minus a. X value 1, assumed mean value 5. So that 1 minus 5, we get minus 4. you should be very careful about minus symbol. Then x value 2 minus assumed mean 5, so that we get minus 3. Then x value 3 minus assumed mean 5, so that we get minus 2. In the same way, you should follow. Here, you should be very careful. X value 6, our assumed mean value is 5. That is 6 minus 5, we get 1. 7 minus 5, we get 2. 8 minus 5, we get 3. And so on. Should be very careful about this column. So that you can solve the problem very easily. Then, FD column. How to find out FD column? Name itself indicating FD, which means F into D. We already found this D column. So that F into D. 21 into minus 4, we get minus 84. You should be very careful about minus here. 30 into minus 3, we get minus 90. 28 into minus 2, we get minus 56. 40 into minus 1, we get 40. Here, 31 into 1, 34. No minus symbol here. 40 into 2, 80. Nothing is given here, means it is understood plus symbol. We have plus. At the same time, 57 into 5, 285. How we get n value? If we sum up all these frequency values, we get n value. N is nothing but total, that is number of frequencies. Here, if we sum up all these frequency values, we get 300. In the same way, you should bring all the minus values aside and plus values aside, so that simplification will be very easy. After simplifying this, summation FD value is 216. So that, let me read out once again the formula. X bar is equal to A plus or minus summation FD by N. In this case, I have taken my assumed mean as 5. Summation FD, that is 216. N value 300. Look at the formula. X bar is equal to A, that is 5, my assumed mean is 5, summation FD value, that is 216, N value, that is 300. If we simplify this, we get 5.72. Thank you. Thank you for your patience listening.